Welcome, I'm Jonathan Mosley. I'm the director of the Animal Sciences Farms and Research Centers. Today we're out at the Feed Technology Center to take a look at some of the equipment that we got donated to help us get this facility up and going this year.
Behind me here we have our GEM bagging system. So this was donated by GEM, and what it all is basically a bagging hopper with a scale, which is also attached to a Union Special sewing machine. And that will then come down two conveyors and come to our GEM robot, which will palletize all of our bag diets. So we're very fortunate that Bühler was willing to donate most of our processing equipment here. So here we have a 5-ton per hour belt drive pellet mill from Bühler, which is a really large improvement over what was at the old animal science feed mill, where we had a pellet line, but it was not functioning for quite some time. Also behind me, we have a 4,400 pound paddle mixer, as well as a multi-impact Bühler hammer mill upstairs.
One of the safety components of the Feed Technology Center is 4B Components donated us some speed sensor switches to allow us to monitor the speed of all of our legs.
The University of Illinois is a global leader in research and teaching in the fields of animal nutrition, animal science, feedstuff utilization, and feed and pet food manufacturing. And with the construction of the new state-of-the-art Feed Technology Center, it will allow the University of Illinois and the College of ACES to really accelerate scientific discovery in these areas. The animal science feed, feed technology, the grain storage, and the processing techniques that are required for that. And so some of those processing techniques include pelleting, crumbling, and extrusion. And what this ultimately does is actually, the aim is to improve the efficiencies and the sustainability in the food production processes. And then the Feed Technology Center and those processing capabilities, what that's really going to allow is for us to really expand the research, teaching, and even the outreach programs that we have. And ultimately what that does is allow us to really create groundbreaking and transformative research initiative opportunities.
Again, we'd like to thank all of our donors that have helped us get to where we are today. As you can see, we've got some really state-of-the-art equipment, and we're anxious to see how this can play into the future for animal nutrition and the university as a whole.